up everyone at YouTube? I hope you guys had a beautiful week. So I got something special for you guys. To further update on the RWB, I'm actually out in Cali now. And the reason why I came out here is to build my wheels, to show you guys how the wheels look, you know, as far as the design aspect of them. They're custom one-off wheels. The wheels are completely designed from scratch. I designed these myself. You guys are gonna see it firsthand. And I wanted to bring you guys along so you can see the whole process of the whole machine, the faces, you know, the assembly of the wheels, so you guys can get a better understanding of the stages that wheels go to, especially three-piece wheels when you order three-piece wheels. So right now, as I mentioned, I'm in Cali. I'm with my buddy Rodney. I'm also with my buddy Danny. He came out with me from New York. So we met up with Matt. Matt is the guy that's going to be machining my wheels, and I'm going to take you inside so I can show you guys exactly what that looks like. Let's go in and see what it looks like, so you guys can see the whole machine process and see how sick that is.
All right, so the process for my wheels, right? So walk me through what would happen. All right, so we would take the forging, right?
Yeah, so we got the forgings, and then we did the lathe operations, right? To get up to this point.
Right.
So that just does all, like, the churning.
Yeah.
Just to get the profile right. And we got them for, like, the fronts and the rears. The main difference is the pad height to get your offset. Because, like, everything attaches on this flange.
Right.
And this is where it sits onto the rotor, you know? So that height dictates how much offset you have with your hoops in it.
Right.
So once we go to the lathe operations, we're going to load it up into the mill. I got these custom-made jaws that's built off of a lathe chuck that's going to hold it in and clamp it. And then we're just going to start cutting out all the pockets and windows and the sides and everything.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
So when you run, like, the programs to kind of, like, mock up, like, what the faces are, So you do that to specifically see if it's going to interfere with, like, the integrity of the face, or let alone, because the last thing you want to do is have freaking faces that crack or anything, right?
So it's exactly. So that all comes from the designer.
Yeah.
I can get, like, the design program up and kind of, like, walk through it a little bit.
Okay.
And so this is your wheel, right?
Right.
So we had the forging, and then we designed out the profile, right?
Right.
And we took it to the lathe shop to get turned. Now we're gonna go from this lathe profile, right?
Right.
Just gonna come into that. So we're gonna have to mill out all of that.
We got the profile. That's my wheel. Yeah, that's my.
Yeah.
So for you guys at home, that's my wheels right there. That's the wheels that we designed.
This is it, man. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's gonna go from this to this. It's basically the right shape, but it just doesn't have any of, like, the windows cut out or anything like that.
Oh my God, look at that.
Up of it.
Jeez.
Yeah.
And that's with a, 5-inch lift? So that's the front. Oh my goodness, dude.
Yeah, this one's 6.5. Oh, this is the rear, I think.
Oh, that's the rear?
Yeah. It's pretty crazy, man.
I mean, still, look at that.
Yeah, so, I mean, once we go back and forth on, like, the design side of things.
Right.
Then it goes over to CAM, which is computer aided manufacturing.
Uh-huh.
So I take the solid model that we have over there, plug it into this program. In this program, I design all, like, the tool paths that control the mill, right?
Right.
So it's the same thing, right?
Uh-huh.
But this program has, like, my library of all the tools I have standard inside this machine, right?
Gotcha.
So it's all, like, different diameters, different lengths, like a ball end mill, square end mill, drills, all that kind of stuff.
So this is what you, from here, this is what you put in to basically tell the
machine what to do.
Yeah, tell the machine what to do. Right?
Exactly, yeah. So I tell the same thing, like, this is what I want to be cut, and then I give it, like, the profile too.
Right.
And then I start going one feature at a time, like, drill those.
Like with the lugs of the...
Yeah, like pre-drill them. This is the custom form tool to get the final shape.
Gotcha.
And then I have like a circular pattern for all, every single thing. So I kind of start with the pre-drill, and then let's see.
See, this is what you're paying for, yeah. The labor of all of this that you guys at home don't know, you just, you know, you see a face and you choose what wheels you want and what color and that's it. You have the easiest part of the job.
Yeah.
These guys got the hard part, man.
Every feature takes multiple paths to get it, right? Let me try to run a simulation for you. So it's like what the machine would do, right?
Oh, wow. I didn't even know it does that too, so it runs like a simulation of
whatever. Just to make sure, and I have all my tools drawn up to make sure it doesn't crash or anything like that.
So this is exactly what the machine is going to do?
Yeah, basically, this is what it's supposed to do.
What? That's crazy.
Yeah, just to make sure everything looks good as best as possible, simulation prior to running the machine.
Oh my, yeah, that's sick. Look at that.
So those are the windows, some of the details getting cut out.
Oh, shit. You're literally watching the wheel transform right before your eyes.
That's it, man. It's making big blocks metal and the smaller blocks metal.
Look how many passes it got to do.
Yeah, because this one, to get in between these channels, you got to use a pretty small end mill.
Right.
So, smaller end mill, less material removal, more passes. So, what I do is I do a rough and finish pass. Rough to get most of the material out.
Right.
And the finish pass to make sure like the walls are like intolerance and super clean, good finishes on them. Okay, here, this is the interesting part. This is doing the surfacing for those spokes. Slow it down a little bit.
Dude.
But to get that curvature,
there's gonna be so many tiny passes.
You have to use a ball end mill and slowly work your way over
the curve
entire
to do that curvature. Yeah, look at
it. Yeah.
Wow. Does it give you a prediction of how long the machine time will be?
Yeah. So this one.
So on my wheel right now.
In a perfect world, we're at like 4.5 hours. But then on the machine, things kind of could take long.
Of course.
Tool changes.
Of course.
It's not ideal.
Right.
It kind of gives you a little ballpark.
Wow. It's crazy. It's like I'm already blown away watching it on the computer, so imagine watching the machine actually cutting it out.
Yeah, in real life.
I might have to like set up my GoPro, my Osmo to just like have it just... Yeah. My face pressed up against the glass, wait.
Hey, Robin, this is the part they couldn't lathe it because it didn't have the red tool set up.
Okay.
So what we have to do is take a small end mill and just ramp all the way down slowly to get that little curve. Okay. But, I mean, I think it's going to be worth it. For like the center cap, to kind of sit up, like on a little pedestal right there.
Yeah,
it looks so much better, dude.
Yeah. So now it's just pre-drilling the holes for the assembly bolts around.
Right.
And then just opening them all up.
Jeez.
That's about it.
Can't wait to see how these come out.
This one wheel, like, this is all over here on this side. All the tool paths required just to make that.
Dude, this whole
one wheel.
This whole list right here. That's all the tools right here?
All different commands. Yeah.
Wow. It's probably at least, looks like almost 20.
It's a lot, yeah.
Yeah, like.
Yeah, every feature needs its own path to make sure, like, it gets cut. That's it.
Wow.
hookers.
So Matt, what do you think of the wheel design that we came up with?
Huh? Sick.
Sick?
I've never seen anything like this, you know?
Yeah.
And it's like, I don't know, put our heads together.
Sick. I can't wait to see this.
Let's meet this viewer already.
Yeah.
So what, as far as this, like?
Yeah. So, all of this.
All the commands over there that you were talking about?
Yeah. Like, what we do is you post-process it, right? So
right.
It goes from the computer, it generates a file for a specific machine, right? So
right.
Like I have a Haas DM6. And then it spits out this code that commands it like an XYZ,
right,
you know?
Right.
Because this is a three-axis mill. So it tells it, use what tool, tells like the RPM, the feed rate, and then it tells it where to go
right.
And everything, right? For all these features. So like the file gets like super, super long.
Holy crap.
Yeah, this is just yeah. Like for this, like with all the surfacing, it could be like over like 10,000 lines of code, right?
Jeez.
Yeah, easily, you know? But shit, yeah, I mean, computer's doing all the work. It makes it easy for us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then you just
yeah.
It comes over to this.
Yeah, let's see, it turned off. Oh, I had the automatic turn off when I finished up that
yeah.
Cycle. But yeah, funny thing is you just toss onto a USB.
Right? Oh shit. Yeah, yeah.
In,
yeah, right? Yeah.
Transferred over to the machine. And yeah, then it just goes line by line.
And then you just basically close this up.
Yeah.
And it gets it started and it
exactly.
Just starts.
So, but you gotta be careful. You have to like make sure that everything in your simulation is what's on the machine.
Right.
Make sure you're not, cause like that's not gonna give you a warning. Like if you just run through metal, like it's not gonna tell you.
Right.
You see it and you hear it.
Then you're like, oh wait a minute.
Yeah.
Emergency stop.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So,
sick. So now the next stop is actually seeing these get turned into what you saw on the computer.
Just doing a little warm-up process right now. Just trying to find where the table is, cycle tools.
Oh, and that's the tools up there.
Tools, yeah. So this machine yeah. Has 40 tools.
Dude, look at that. That's crazy.
Yeah.
So it pulls the tool out and...
Yep.
Oh,
yeah,
wow.
Yeah, I can do a tool change for you there now.
Yeah. Oh crap.
Oh shit.
Oh.
Yep, that's the next tool.
Do another one? You see it? Oh. Yo, that's crazy.
So all the tools have different diameters,
right, and
different lengths
and bits, right? Like the,
yeah, this is like a square bottom end mill,
right?
You have your ball end mill, full like corner radius ones. You have drills, you have taps. Face mills. You got a bunch of shit.
I don't even want to know how much something a machine like this costs because I could.
Whatever you pay for the machine, you got to pay like half that in tooling.
God, dude.
Yeah, because one thing I did, I upgraded everything to these hydraulic holders.
Uh-huh.
So it's a lot different than your just like typical side mount holders.
Right.
All you gotta do is tighten this hex over here, and then there's hydraulic fluids that come and clamp onto the tool, right?
Right.
So one, it's really good gripping force. Two, it's super concentric. The runout's perfect. And yeah, it's great for hogging out material, you know?
This is unbelievable, dude. Unbelievable. And people think three-piece wheels, oh, I don't get why they're so expensive.
There's a lot that goes
again, into. Yeah, they don't realize it's so much.
Yeah.
Just from the materials all the way up to this point.
Yeah.
And then that's not even including your finishes, your plating.
No.
You know.
Yeah, I mean, after the mill, it goes to prep, polish, and everything.
Right,
and
right.
Some dude has to just kind of like blend out all the machine marks.
Yep.
And then, yeah, painting, assembly, it's a lot of stuff, man. Yeah. Wow. You know, these are like some custom jaws that we made.
Yeah.
Just to hold the wheel, you know, because like you,
this.
Yeah, you have to hold the metal inside the machine,
right,
without it flying away, you know. So yeah, those are just custom made here, you know.
Some machines use water, right?
Yeah. Yeah. So.
Oh, so you actually
a bunch
do?
Of cooling.
Yeah. Okay. So yours.
Turn it on real quick.
Gotcha. Gotcha. Okay. So basically, I mean, you need that to cool down from the friction of the...
Yeah, so when you're cutting, it generates a lot of heat.
Right.
You know? So what the coolant does is, one, just manages the heat. It lubricates the cut because it's water and oil.
Right.
For the most part. But then, the really important part is it blows away the chips. You know? So, it, like, all your metal shavings aren't just being nested into the same spot, and you're not recutting chips.
Right.
It's not good for your tool life or anything like that, and it messes up.
It also messes up the wheel.
So you gotta blow it away. You know.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
So Matt, what are you doing right now?
Just in the jaws, got these guys fit the outer profile of the forgings.
Right.
Yeah, so I gotta scoot them in a little bit.
Right.
Just to make sure it's the right diameter and we have enough clearance off of here to the pad.
Gotcha. Yep. So this is what my faces are going into. 18x13.5. So that's a 6.5-inch inner. And my outer, which is, you know, my lip, that's a 7-inch lip. Insane. I can't wait to see these wheels done. So when Matt finishes doing machining one of the centers, we're gonna mock it up and you guys can see the final product of like what it's gonna look like, which is before, you know, powder coating in. Cause I'm gonna chrome, that lip is polished, but I'm gonna chrome that lip out and then gonna powder the center. Thinking of doing like a copper color since the car's black. Gonna go with a black and copper theme. Alright, so what's happening right now is that actually got a friend of ours by the name of Edgar. Edgar's the one with the camera. You know, meanwhile, while I'm vlogging all this stuff, showing you guys how everything is going on, well, we wanted like a more like professional kind of like video of like just a quick start to finish of the whole process. So Edgar's basically doing that. He's the one. So that, aside from you guys seeing like the actual vlogging of me talking and explaining stuff, I'm gonna also post up the finished product of what Edgar does of like the start to finish. Yeah, Edgar's getting a few shots of Matt putting the forgings in and basically strapping the forgings down so the machining process could get started. Guys, so like literally I think 6-7 hours later we finally finished cutting that center. It's just so many passes had to be made to make that center face. It's crazy the amount of work that Matt had to put into making that thing happen, but now we're about to pull it out of the machine and then we're gonna mock it up with the barrels, like the lip and everything, so you guys can see what they will look like. Remember, it's not powder coated. The lip is only currently polished now. I'm gonna chrome out the lip. I'm gonna do a copper, like a translucent or transparent copper, because I want to do like a black and copper theme on the car. I'm about to show you guys how the drill look now. Yo, it looks sick. Look how crazy this is. Remember we started off with literally started off with this, like 6 hours later it turns into this, exactly what you showing what you guys saw on the computer. Yeah, dude.
Yo, guys, my heart was skipping a beat when Matt pulled it out of the machine, and that's when I really saw the profile of it. Sick. Shit, here we go.
Yeah, that's an RWB wheel. That's an RWB wheel.
Holy shit.
Yeah, it's like, you see the
standard. Andrew, you want to stand on a chair?
The lip itself.
Actually,
you see the what?
It's the reflection.
See snake.
It's been a long day.
No, I was telling you, I was like, to me, like, I find this shit like fascinating. Yeah. Like,
you guys saw the start to finish. And that finish is, man, even just raw, it looks crazy. Next and last step would be, you know, getting them powdered, doing the copper centers like I mentioned, and getting the chrome plating on the barrels, well, the lip. I can't wait, dude. I'm tired, I'm excited. I can't even explain to you. And I could even do it without these guys, man.
Comes again.
These are the guys of the hour right here. Rodney, Matt, Danny for helping me pick out the design.
You're welcome.
Oh, man. The crunching of hours that you put in.
In the last 24 hours, man.
I know, man. You stayed up till 3 in the morning last night finishing the programming and then...
Just running it all today, proving it out, man.
And then coming here and then still doing a whole nother shift in OT.
Yep.
Just to run this.
Yeah, man.
So we could get this end product right here.
12
hours. Jeez.
Yeah.
You guys are the best, man. Rodney for the opportunity.
Yeah,
Matt for the opportunity. Wait till Edgar puts out the video. That's what I really want to see when Edgar does the feature video. So really appreciate you guys. It's the end of this episode, and when Matt puts out his the feature video of everything coming together, that's gonna look sick. I'm gonna post that too. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Till next time, peace.